So this is part two of the IMR of the weekend of 29th May. So we are starting a new month, June, in the next few hours. And these are the notes that we made from part one that we did day before yesterday. And essentially what we were saying is, looks like the market has suddenly turned extremely bullish. And from the 3-week very bearish view that we had, especially last week, and saying shorts only, now it looks like longs only. And we were talking about the head and shoulder formation on the Nifty, which looks like it might break out on the neckline after the breakdown a couple of days back. And we had this really great move on Friday, that too after expiry, on really exceptional volumes, where the market went up on volumes that have not been seen for quite a few months. And as we also saw on many of the sector indices, there's a lot of strength. So absolutely no sector at all where we could say, you know, we should be shorting, etc. And just to bring the S&P here back again, the Nifty. So this is where it is at a very crucial juncture on that uptrend, downtrend line. And if I put that 7-month neckline that we're talking about, then this is the one where it's possibly at, just at that junction. It'll be very interesting to see what happens in the next couple of days, whether that gets broken out. And if it does, then as we said, given the volumes we saw on Friday, these very, very impressive volumes, we could see much higher levels, maybe even 9,000 back on the Nifty. Right? So with that, we'll look at the individual stocks now. And as usual, our new format, we'll start with sectors, and we'll start with the auto sector. So in the auto sector, we look at Bajaj Auto first in the Nifty, and we've seen the Bajaj Auto has very impressively gone from around 2000 levels about a month back to 2350. And if you remember, we kept talking about this bullish divergence, which has handsomely paid off. We've got some excellent Marubozus on Bajaj Auto. And while it's really difficult to interpret the volume here because you've got this exceptionally high volumes on account of results and I'm sure some big time, big ticket buying, but that left aside, this is definitely looking like a flag. So from about 1950 or even 2000 to be conservative to 2300, that's a 15% move. That's very impressive. And that's consolidation. And another 300 rupee move would make this go to 2600, which is a little shy of the life high at around 2675. There's of course the resistance at 2350 and 2500. So Bajaj Auto is definitely a long with multiple supports now at lower levels. So you've got one support here for short-term traders, I would say, which is below 2255. And then you've got this whole bunch of moving averages here, which could provide a lot of support in the days ahead if it moves down. Any move down on the stock should now be looked upon as a buying opportunity. And remember that this 300 rupee move took 1, 2, 3, 4 weeks to happen. So even if it goes up at the same rate the whole of June, and it takes another 300 rupees, that will be absolutely fine. Even if it takes longer, it will be absolutely fine. So after doing a 15% move, we're talking about another almost 15% move, 12% move. Shouldn't expect, you know, shouldn't be too greedy, but it can happen. So if you look at this, for example, previously, when we were from 2000 to 2600, it took 1, 2, 3, 4 months. So even if this is just 1 month, so this is a much faster move. And even if this takes another 2 months to do that, that's absolutely fine. But like I said, the next target is 2600, and then depending on your trader or investor, you can put an appropriate stop loss. So that's on Bajaj. Let's look at Hero Motors. So that's also really gone up, and on Friday went up again, broke all the long-term moving averages in the last 2 weeks, and Friday's move was impressive. However, you are not seeing a good volume on Friday. This Thursday's high volume could be on account of expiry, we don't know. And if you sort of discount this, then the Friday's move is definitely on higher volumes compared to the previous one and a half weeks. So I think the I would go on the side of a high volume move, and below 2575, or actually below 2550 would be a good stop loss. But otherwise, first target for this is 2750, and then I would say 3000, and that's for Hero Motors. Next, coming to M&M. So I think that there's around some really results which the market was happy about, if I'm not wrong. Please correct me if I'm wrong. We also spoke a couple of weeks back about the new joint venture that M&M has with the Japanese specialist agricultural equipment manufacturer. So not sure whether all this is combined or just results, but definitely impressive move on very, very good volumes. And it's above 1250 now, close at 1258. Little premature to say that's a breakout there of that resistance, but given the way the volumes have been on Friday, I think more or less this is a good breakout. And once this is able to clear this zone at around 1300, I would say, then I think it's back to life high 1400 very quickly. And difficult to put a stop loss on this, but for a trader, I would say put it halfway through this Marubozu at below 1210. For a trader, first stop on the target side 1300, and then life high 1400, and then the new life high quite possibly. Right, so that is the call on M&M. And then we look at Maruti. So Maruti finally making a new life high. Not a little too early. Little shy of the life high. They're definitely there. Falling volumes, and then volumes have picked up in the last on Friday, Thursday, Friday. Earlier, if you remember, we were talking about selling the 4,000 call, saying that there's overall weakness in the market. Well, now we may have to sort of relook at that and probably look at essentially going long on the market. Once above 3850, I think that 4,000 is a possibility. You would not want to write 4,000 calls at this point. Again, showing a comeback of strength. And if there is a stop loss that one needs now, then it would be somewhere below 3550 in my opinion. So look at this level, and if it breaks down, then you get out of the long. But otherwise, it would definitely be on the uptrend. So that is Maruti for you. And then we have Tata Motors. So big gap on Tata Motors. I think again it was results that were not up to the mark. But having said that, definitely something interesting here in Tata Motors, which is a bullish divergence. And here it is. So if you look at that, and even if you look at the RSI, so it's very mild at this point, but so RSI 31.7 there, RSI 29.6, and this was a lower low but a higher high there, and maybe even in MACD. So I'll just MACD, if I put a downtrend line, and that's been broken, and we could be seeing some support happen there. This is not a normalized MACD, unfortunately, but if it was, I'm suspecting we may be having a mega oversold condition or the likes of that, and this may be an opportunity to actually enter Tata Motors. So there is, first of all, notice, oh amazing, this trend, this support line that we had put, how it came there on Wednesday. Thursday went up, Friday just a sort of a little bit of a cool off. So gap down happened here, but you can see that it gapped down with high volumes, and then after that there's been some buying again, and then there's some profit taking perhaps. This support has been revalidated and has become stronger now, 470. So it's a high risk trade. I think you have much better trade on Bajaj, Hero Motors, M&M. But if one is looking for maybe a laggard type trade, which could give maybe higher returns, then you have the opportunity to go long here with a stop loss at around 463. First target is 500. It should probably happen. There's a gap window here that needs to be closed. Actually, that window, attempt to close the window started on Thursday itself. Friday, a little bit closure, more closure, but I think next week it should go back up. Resistance is all the way in every 510 rupees till 520. Once it clears 520, 540, then you could see a much bigger move to 600. Okay. But again, be really, really patient on that. All right. So that is Tata Motors. Then, so we have finished all the auto stocks. So essentially a good flag on Bajaj. Okay. Right, we also have M&M, good volumes. So if you're going long, Tata Motors would be the black sheep trade. Okay, next we look at cement. So I'm just mixing it up so the mind actually doesn't trust with the same flow. So cement on Friday, ACC, okay, up on definitely higher volumes. These volumes are highest for I think 3 weeks now. That's something definitely to note, which brings us to definitely a good potential long-term transaction, long-term trade with a stop loss below 1450. First target 1550, which I expect is going to get broken out in the coming week, and then 1600 is the next target, and then maybe even 1650. So we had a 1750 to 1400 correction, and now maybe the uptrend has started again. So we need to keep a track of that. Next is Ambuja. So Ambuja, alright, so Ambuja's volumes are definitely healthier. As a matter of fact, Ambuja would, I think, be the preferred buy, not ACC at this point. Support is nice and healthy at 225. It's come to a old lifetime high of 237, and its volume picture is definitely better. So I would go with Ambuja. Stop loss is definitely below 222. That's quite a bit of a move, actually, 225 to 240. So if you're doing F&O, that's quite a bit of M2M you'll have to look at. But once it crosses 240, 243, then 250 first target, and then even 265 is quite possible. Of course, it will take maybe a couple of weeks to do that. If the monsoons are good, remember that cement sales are not really great, so sometimes these stocks don't perform, I think, very clear during this quarter. But that's just something I haven't validated with data. If somebody wants to do that, please do that and update me with the results. Okay, next, Grasim. So Grasim is not a very good volume. It is sort of looks like This took that support, 200 day moving average there, 3500 psychological mark, but a nice healthy marubozu. And once it's up crossing 3700, then well, 38 and then 3950, then who knows, maybe even 4000, and a nice stop loss I think here at 3467. So a lot of moves on Friday have been like marubozu, big multi-person moves, so that's why the stop losses are going to be a little low. And but that's just the nature of the game, like there's sometimes it's going to be like this and really nothing much we can do about it. Okay, so this is Grassim, and we have right the view on Grassim, and then Ultratech. Okay, so overall, if I look at all now, Ultratech again has started to outperform. If you go back and compare Ambuja versus ACC versus Grassim versus Ultratech, and Ultratech is definitely doing higher tops, higher bottoms. Volume picture is definitely, I think, the best of the lot. And if you had to buy, then definitely Ultratech would be the one with a very nice stop loss below 2800. Be patient, 3100 and then 3200 and then perhaps even a life high of 3350. And that is the trend that you want to keep a track of. All right, so that is Ultratech. So cement all good, and Ultratech, then I should say Ambuja, then Grassim, all longs, right? Okay, next, I'm just going by this classification that's there on the NSE, it's sometimes not very good. So in the sort of capital goods, construction, conglomerate type space, you have L&T, so looking at that, so we know the capital goods index broke out of a multi-year level. And so what L&T has done is, first of all, it broke down from this multi-month most extreme trend line that one could have put. There was a head and shoulder, you know, top there, but not a very good rally, so the validity of that is always in question. It did a breakdown but really didn't follow through, and then it has gone back up through that trend line, and it has done that on very good volumes, and the next level would be 1700 to look at. So L&T is also a buy. With, you could look at the 200-day moving average here, stop loss. So I would say going below 1570, actually not even 1570, 1590 is a good enough stop loss. Initial small resistance, I would say at 1690, and once that goes 1690, 1700, then 1750, 1800 is definitely the next good target for L&T. Just to reiterate something on L&T, it only recently broke its you know, multi-year level. Actually, not recently, as in it broke in 2014, came back, and this last 1 year has been a really good sort of, I think, test consolidation for it. this is a very long-term chart. Right, this whole zone, I would say, has been that sort. You can see the low volumes and then the volume pickup here, and again, you know, doing that slightly higher volume again in this phase. This part, if I may point out here, in Feb March is where I think it sort of set the mood for what it wants to do over the long term. And this, after breaking this multi-year, almost 7 year resistance, could be in for some significant move up in the many quarters and years ahead. So that's just a very long term picture on L&T. Right. Okay. Then we have, all right, we come to the consumer goods space. So in that is included FMCG and whatever it starts with. Asian paints. So Asian paints, almost all stocks and sectors, as you will see in the last 3-4 months, have gone sideways after doing a multi-month rally. And Asian paints, at least 200-day moving average, has turned out to be a very, very important and a tenacious support level. It went through that for almost 5 weeks, and then you had a high volume down move that really didn't make the stock go very much down, I would say. Just looks like a lot of people bought after that, and yesterday again on Friday a nice up move. After a period of consolidation, perhaps looking at going up, would buy this only after it goes above 800, so 805, let's say, would be a nice entry target for that. And then at that time, with a trading stop loss, say about 780, long-term investor stop loss would be only below 750. First stop 850, after that 900. Next, coming to our FMCG pack, we start with Hindustan Unilever. And hasn't really corrected, has it? Unlike many of the other stocks, it really hasn't corrected from the 950, just put 950 to 850. That's about, 10%? Well, actually in line with the overall market. But many of the other stocks have corrected much more, 20-30%. It's done a 10% correction, gone sideways again for the last 4 weeks. But on Friday, like we are seeing this picture again and again, it's gone up on much higher volumes than for actually many, many months. So that is something again to keep a note of. Quite possibly these are moves with the start of perhaps much bigger moves that could evolve in the weeks ahead. Really nothing on the weekly chart. Okay, all right. So first target would be 885, and once 885 goes, then 940 and then 950, and I think there is excellent support here at 828, and wouldn't chicken out just unless some really bad news or some event like that happens. I think it's very unlikely to go below 816 or even below it come to 836. One could look at buying it with, like I said, first target at 885, 900, and then 950. And if it can break that 950,000 level, first time it will be doing that, and it sort of becomes a four-digit stock and might hesitate again. And please note, this has this tendency, looks like, to do this stepwise moves on its behavior, unlike other stocks which that sort of just keep trending up. This one is like on very ladder type moves that it seems to have. So just pointing out about how some stocks have certain personalities. Next, we'll do ITC. So I think the results were not very happy for ITC, and having said that, right, so having said that, 315 could support, and this definitely is looking like a a descending triangle, let's say from mid-April, which is on the verge of a breakout. Volumes on Friday were definitely good. On Thursday also, they were healthy. And this could make it go to 340, 350, and then who knows, we could go all the way to 375 after that. The measuring implication is from 350 to 315, 50 about 40 bucks. So from here, 370 is a very possible target with all the intermediate, of course, resistance that we'll have to take out in between. Right. So this is ITC. Now, all right, great. So both ITC. So ITC. We have a descending triangle with a potential breakout, HUL minus the 10% reaction that take the stock to 1000 plus levels. All right. Then we have witnessed FMCG. Now let's look at energy. So looking at BTCL first. Oh, whoa, it's made a new life high. It just shot up. That is definitely impressive. 840, 850. And that's done it on good volumes. We definitely want to buy BTCL. 780 was great support. Now, as a trader, stop loss is only below 820. I wouldn't actually get out on any stop loss, but buy on every dip that is there and be very patient on this. This stock is headed to 1000 in not too distant future, right? So that is definitely something that this is on its way to achieving. All right, so to move that up. Okay, next coming to Kane. So Kane has been a surprise, definitely. In spite of rising crude oil prices, this has really not reacted. It's really gone down quite significantly from 370 to 190 now. And we were looking at much lower targets given this breakdown of 200, let's say maybe even 150. So we've got some high volume activity now appearing in the last 1 week, and a sort of basing out of the stock would even okay, let's just look at weekly. What you have to notice on the weekly chart is MACD golden crossover, that's still in the negative zone, and the RSI perhaps giving a multi-month bullish divergence, which it's already failed once, remember that. Really unusual to look at monthly, but yep. Last 3 months the volume has definitely been reducing on the downside, so I'm just suspecting whether the stock is sort of, at least if not, definitely not towards the end, but in the midst of starting a basing formation. So it's found some support at some low levels, and I'm not sure, but okay, yeah, we'll have to wait for this level very carefully. 190, if you are looking for I don't know, this is way too, I'm just putting an idea out here based on a discussion we're having with the most important thing, whether there's deep value in this stock or not. I don't know, don't have fundamental picture about this, but if it does, then you know, this could be really a good contrarian buy with a very nice stop loss below 188, and it's also left the lower Bollinger band, so that is something added to its slightly bullish picture. Though the trend is very, very clearly down at this moment, but if you're looking for a low risk, low stop loss trade, then I would think about recommending this. So BPCL is of course life high must buy. And we have Kane saying contrarian buy, and you know, one more reason is the strength that is there in the Nifty, which we should not ignore. Okay, so if it holds on to this 190, which it really could at this point, in 200 that's a clear 5-6% move, and once it crosses 200, then maybe even 210, and definitely 220, 225 after that, which is all, you know, quite healthy. So that's really a good percentage return that you'll be getting. So you may want to consider this. Okay, so that's the view on Kane, and then let's look at the rest. Gale, alright, so that's broken out of a downtrend, and that's very significant. It's done quite a bit of drama actually. But oh wow, okay, so again we're looking at multi-month high volume buying here. I'm not sure Wednesday, Thursday, what happened, maybe results, please check. But 1370 is now excellent support, right? The low here is 370, the low here is 370.45, as good as the tweezers bottom. You could go along with a stop loss at around 368, 367. Some hesitation before it breaks out from 400, 410. Right? But once that breakout happens, then I think going to 450 quickly would easily happen. And if I may point out, so let's actually do this. Yo, we could be having, not good, we are having definitely a head and shoulder bottom on this, so that is your neckline. Okay, even if I stretch it to its limits of putting it on the highs, and measuring implication would be from about 355 to 400, that is 45 rupees, and it is at say 390 plus 45, we're talking about 435. And that is more or less that. Alright, so of course there will be resistance at 400, 410, but 430, 435 is the target on that. This is more than 10% move on that, on the stock, so definitely something to look at. So Gale, head and shoulder bottom, 20%. Possible. All right, so that is Gale for us, and then we've got NTPC. So all this is in the energy pack. All right, so so first of all, high volume for the week itself. We've got a spinning top, and massive volume on Friday. This is, I again, like I said in part one, I'm not sure what is going on. These sort of volumes are in some cases multi-month, I mean many cases multi-month, and in some cases multi-year high volume. So I mean, what's changed so significantly in the market is something I've not been able to put my finger on. But this is looking really healthy now, and downtrend line should break down. That should get broken. So that is the downtrend line. If you look at this one, and that's definitely broken. If I put an outer one, it did break intraday, but cooled off. Is profit booking, I suppose. I would say that we're looking at long position here with a stop loss below this low, so below 130, 130. First target 140, then 145, and 145 clears, then definitely 150. Right. So that is NTPC. Then we have MGC. Whoa, that's again very, very good volumes on Thursday and Friday. Friday's volumes, Thursday are surprising, sort of a down move, but Friday. And MACD is just getting stronger and stronger and stronger. RSI is getting stronger. The stochastic is also getting stronger. So I think this is now set for an up move. This downtrend is over 310. I might even recommend this as an investment buy, because of all, like we said, the subsidy pricing is over, the burdens are over, and these stocks should actually perhaps you know, get in the next few, many quarters are be at much higher levels. How high, I don't know, but just to stick my neck out, why not even 1,000 rupees? So I'm talking about a 300% return on ONGC. Let it take 3 years, it doesn't matter, but I think that's definitely feasible now. And yep, so this is a bit of a stretch, but again there is a symmetrical triangle on the stock. And if that breaks out, then that itself is like a 10% move, and once that happens, then 360 and then even higher. So okay, so Gale Legendary ONGC symmetrical triangle 1% target up. Alright, so very, very unusual to find so many good buys all in such quick succession. So something definitely up to the market, like I said. So Power Grid, definitely a laggard compared to the other ones that we've seen, has no volume, so you could just stay away from it. But on the other hand, it's a contrarian thing, rounding bottom happening there, not really great volumes to coincide with that, but you know, hey, this could have been a premature attempt here, breakout didn't happen, so like a double saucer in the volumes but a single saucer in the price. And once this trend line gets broken above 145, it could just rapidly shoot to 150 and then even 155. Good stop loss would be below 139. Next, Tata Power. So surprising, not much of a move on Friday. Volumes however have definitely picked up, no doubt about that. And a laggard at 75 and will take time to go to 82 in my opinion. This is like a descending, you know, wedge, except that there's no move that was connected directly to it, but still which it has not broken out of. And if it say comes back to, you know, around the 70-72 level, then would possibly be a good buy. And the big move would probably happen only once this upper end of the descending wedge is broken out of, which at the way it is right now could take several weeks to happen. Then if that happens say around 80, then going to 90 rapidly could definitely happen. Remember, look at this, it has gone from 80 to 90, more than a 10% move in less than a month, in about 2 weeks. So it could definitely repeat a 10% move in a very short period of time. Okay, so Tata Power, but no hurry to buy. I think you can look at BPCL and Kane and ONGC and Gale, and wait for Tata Power to actually give us a better buy signal. Finally, Reliance. So very interesting. Reliance hasn't done anything on Friday. As a matter of fact, a filled candle, low volumes for the whole of May, did high volume on Thursday and Friday only. So this was the whole of May, low volume. This is why we were talking about the bull trap earlier. Broke down, but is this the trend line that we should be looking for, rather than, you notice it connects much better with the lows. Given the high volume, it's, I would say, a wait and watch game, given that it's not gone up. But so very nice symmetrical triangle on weekly chart, as you can see. And I think it's just a matter of next 2 weeks before this breaks out one way or the other. And if it does that, so let's put that here also. Right. So this is really interesting. Lots of symmetrical triangles, lots of maybe even head and shoulder bottoms that are in the market simultaneously. And if you look at this one, this measuring implication is quite large. 100 rupees. So let's say breakout at around 900, that makes it go to 1000. And it's overall the falling volume in inside the symmetrical triangle was textbook picture, and it, I guess it's waiting for a breakout to happen, and that's the time to buy it. As a matter of fact, you could even buy it now, given that it's perhaps the lower end of the symmetrical triangle, right? Okay, so 900 1050 is possible on Reliance. Cool. So we have done with energy. Now let's go and do IT. So HCL Tech. So rupee depreciating a bit. HCL Tech. Well, there you have it. On Friday, a live high. Patience is the key, I guess. In this, you'd already mentioned on an uptrend. I think if you look at the last one or two IMR, you said perhaps the only sector which is worth looking at buying was IT, in spite of all the rest of the market going down. And if one had followed that, it looks like I think 1,000 rupees coming there is quite possible. Going to the life high was just a matter of time. And this time it's probably, you know, once again, four digit stock now it has become. I never done that. And who knows where this could go. This could just be jumping in 1,500 rupee terms. And difficult to really give the next target. You buy it with a stop loss. Very investor stop loss below 950, say below 925, 930. And as far as a long term target is concerned, sky's the limit, quite literally, on this. Right? No sign of it weakening at all. Where is that? I don't like too many light colors actually. Okay, so yeah, we have multi-year very bad trend line, so it doesn't fit very well, but some trend line is better than no trend line. So that's the one to keep a track of. Okay, so I'm just checking, started to rain again here in case internet goes or power goes or something. All right, so that was the view on HCL Tech. Definitely a buy when you're looking at Infi. And so comparatively, Infi is a laggard, but again, it's gone up on good volumes on Thursday, Friday, and with the restructuring that's going on. Not sure how well that will pan out for the long term, but if it does, then this stock is definitely something that could be going to a completely different level. So we have Infi there. Once it breaks 2100, because that's where some moving average resistances are, I think once it breaks 2100, then that is when the crossover, move to 2200, and then the next move 2250 could easily happen, right? Okay, so that is HCL Tech, Infi, and DCS. Alright, so TC has also gone up nicely from 2450 to 2600, and a lot of long shadows here, bit of a surprise, but this one has actually, you know, overall the correction has been, I would say, much 10%. It's like, you know, reminded of the HUL stock. We didn't correct much, went sideways mostly, and this level of 2430 has become a very strong support, and I guess the real resistance now for this is the life high of 2750, and then once that goes, then 3000 is very much on the cards, I would think, right? So like a double top there at 2800, and once that gets taken off, then certainly 3000 is coming. Next is Tech Mahindra. Oh, so this is a surprise. So that bad results and 12% down one day. So there is now a huge window, and that might also be a huge window of opportunity, if I may add. So we've got this window, and well, windows need to be closed. And if you subscribe to that view, then it has to go from 5, not now immediately, but it has to go at some point to 630 rupees. And that is going to be something that is a very healthy profit. That's almost 20-25%. So this is the level that has gotten held at this point. So at one point it was a life high. So what would be nice is to actually go and look at the result and see if it is a one-off exceptional result, or is it some change in the fortunes of this company. If it is the former, then could really be a good place to buy. Excellent, very close support at 540, it is at 554. So 17, 18, 20 rupees is the risk, but this could, you know, just go back from here back to 620, 630. So you have that excellent huge volume on the fall, but then again you've got this buying that has been happening. So there's been some definitely question is astute investors who are perhaps getting in and looking at this as an opportunity for sure. And it has not gone below 540. So you could look at that. You could buy the 600 call instead, or the 570, 580 call, and look at how that might pan out. Right? Okay, so Tech Mahindra. And then, so on this Tech M, 12%. Correction, good long term, plus window to be closed. Okay, and then finally Wipro. So if we look at Wipro, we're looking at 540. Right, and so it's like this. This line at 540 has become a really, really good support. Just wondering, I'm curious, on Tech Mahindra you had 540 as a good support, alright? And in Wipro also now you're seeing a good support. I'm not a person who believes in numerology, at least I don't know enough about it. So just observation, wondering whether there's something more to this than meets the eye. And so after this 670 to 540 correction, on in between higher volumes, it looks like some accumulation has happened in this stock at this lower levels. And you could definitely go long on this, except that 570, 580 is going to be some resistance to the moving average of 600. Then and after that 620, right? Very nice long shadow here, almost like a hammer, and a confirmation on Friday here. Minor 2-1 week correction, and then looks like we are headed back up. So everything in the IT space also is a buy. Only thing exception being Tech Mahindra, which is not as healthy as other things, but it could be a good contrarian trade, right? Okay, and TCS is, I think I said, like I said, looking at 3000 in the next 3-4 months. Okay, all right. Now let's look at pharma. So, starting with Cipla. So, well, pharma, the volumes are there, but the price is not there. So, wondering something I mentioned a few sessions back about whether pharma is like not, you know, not the leader of the pack anymore, and whether it's gotten tired after doing, you know, many very, very multi-bagger moves across the sector. So at this point is definitely not looking too strong. You've got a double top at 740, and this is the downtrend line that we're looking at on this side. So 630, good support, 620. I wouldn't say there's any hurry to buy it, but because you've got so many other much better longs. But I'd say just wait and watch and leave it for now. Next is Dr. Reddy's. Excellent volumes again on Dr. Reddy's, but again, no price action. This is there. So, nothing too great on that. So I would again say save, leave it, but 3500 would be a really good support point psychologically, and given that it is more or less there, this gives an opportunity for a very small stop loss. Consolidating looks like, so if you wanted, wouldn't go with Cipla, but could go with Dr. Reddy with a stop loss at say 3472, first target 3650, 3660, and then 3800, and then after that 4000. So in the pharma space, I would definitely look at Dr. Reddy's. Then we have Lupin. So this is, fantastic volumes, fantastic Marubozu. Could see a correction or a continuation on Monday tomorrow. But this is definitely a buy. With a stop loss only below 1661, first target 1900 and then 2000-2100. That would be the target for Lupin. Looks like a basing formation which it has completed and now heading back up to its life high. So Lupin is on the cards. Right, and then we have Sun Pharma. Almost ditto picture like Lupin, right. And there is this window here which has still not been closed. There is an attempt to close it, but what's very clear on Sun Pharma is that this previous life high of around 920 has become a really, really good support. One could definitely look at Sun Pharma with a stop loss below here at around 911. Trade the stop loss, but look at below 945, or be patient till it crosses 1000. Buy it when, say, it's 1005, first target 1050, that's when the window will approximately get closed, and then most probably going back to its life high. So Sun window closure, so 966 to that. 50 CMP is 966. Straight. Okay. So we're done with that. Then we've got metals and banks left. And before we do that, let's look at telecom. I need to look at Bharti. Whoa. What a fantastic move on Bharti, on excellent volume. This is just amazing. 10% move, 400 to 430, 435 almost, went almost to 440. And symmetrical triangle breakout actually happened 3 days before or 2 days before. Very tough to look at the volume here now. Let me have a look. 5 million before that, it was 6 million. So not a high volume breakout, but nevertheless a breakout. Cluster of supports there, right there till 395, 390, and who would have expected such a fantastic move? Whether you're a spot portfolio and if you're doing a derivative, this you would have been extremely happy with this. And it's now coming to a multi-year resistance of around 430, 440. And once that clears, then going to 500 very quickly, I think, is just a matter of time. Again, this is like, Reliance hasn't done anything for many, many years and could be on the verge, I'm wondering, of making move that would compensate for this multi-year underperformance. Just putting a very long-term trend line here, multi-year. Actually fits quite well, as you can see. 2013, the lows. Here, 3 points here in 2014-15. Only here, it wasn't really that good, but this is, well, as good as it gets. and one should keep a track of this long-term trend line. And like I said, once it's beyond, I think, the 330, 340 mark, and 500, 600, and who knows, maybe it gets re-rated to a completely different level. Okay, which means I need to also look at IDEA. So IDEA, definitely one of the performing better than Bharti, for sure. He made a life high of 200 this year. A correction from 200 to 165. We've got a nice sort of double bottom here at this level, plus nice moving average support, 200 day moving average, and definitely no volume picture like in Bharti, but this double bottom, and given the overall state of the market, given this is a downtrend line, I think on the verge of perhaps breaking out, we could look at buying this with a stop loss below 162, and once it's above 175, 180, then 185, 200 is most definitely on the cards with IDEA, right? Okay, so so that's looking nice. And then so both IDEA and Airtel, that we are looking good buys on the telecom side. Bharti of course had the volumes, IDEA doesn't, but nice double bottom on IDEA. Okay, next we come to metals. We've got metals and banks left. So I'll do banks last. On the 2nd of June, we have the RBI policy. So in metals, shouldn't be included, of course, but we've got Coal India there. Or actually, I think maybe that was the mentorship. We just wanted to have a better classification. Okay. So Coal India breaking out of symmetrical triangle. Definitely done that on volumes, is an excellent buy, and well, even if I take it conservatively from here, that's almost from 390 to 350, 40 bucks. So 40 bucks, we're talking about 420 on the stock, 420, 425, we're talking definitely about a life high. Again, remember this 1, 2, 3 months it took for the symmetrical triangle to form and the breakout to happen took a full week. So 425 shouldn't be expected today, tomorrow, next week. It could even take a month. It's absolutely fine. But 425 is coming, and is you could use this as a really good stop loss. Even up to 380 if it comes back, or even to 370 and bounces from there, that would be an excellent second chance to get in. But definitely this is now a buy. Right? You could buy the 400 call option actually on Coal India and see if That will probably give you a much faster and higher percentage return. Okay, so that's Coal India. Look at Hindalco. Weekly chart. Whoa. So this is in a completely different league altogether. Triple bottom, volumes have picked up. Very, very interesting. Also note that this level it is on is actually a multi-year from 2004. This is going to be a really tough one. I am going to stick my neck out on this and give it a contrarian view, because there's absolutely really no reason why you should be buying this. Okay, but given the rest of the market, we might be finding this at an exceptionally, it's definitely at an exceptionally good support level. If the support holds, then you could be in for a very good return, you know what, I would say just go and buy the 130 call on Hindalco, right? 130 June call option, and it could really give you 100-200% returns by the end of the month. If it goes from 130 to 140, 145, and who knows. Okay, I am just opening the USC website, and okay, so we're looking at Hindalco, and we're looking at the options under Hindalco. Okay, let's see what we get. And we're talking about the 130 call option. 130 call option. Ooh. Okay, 4 rupees. 50 paisa, you're looking at 2000 rupees. Oh, sorry, that's the put call option on this side. 134 rupees 60 paisa. This is actually pretty high intrinsic, implied volatility. But anyhow, there's nothing much we can do about it. We're looking at 4 rupees 60. So which means into 2000, we're talking about 9,000 rupees that is on risk approximately. But let's say it's taking a considered view of this. This could easily, I think, in the month go at least 140. That's 10 rupees intrinsic value that could happen. And if that 10 rupees intrinsic value happens on this stock, you're talking about 20,000 rupees that you could make. So there's 9,000 rupees at risk here, 20,000 rupees that could be made. That's 100% return that could be made on the Hindalco 130 call. And in case for some reason after 2-3 months of sideways consolidation this decides to break out from 140 and go to 150, and you can't really rule such things out, see it, what it did from 100 to 130 in 1 month. Imagine if you had a call option here, how much money you would have made. System would be very, very happy that day. 31 lot, 60,000 bucks on just one trade. Oof, that's fantastic. So exceptionally good volume, support. So this just might be your trade of the year. I don't know. I'm just at 130 call option for June. Of course, alternatively would be that you could look at an out of the money option of say 140, much cheaper at 150. It's oof, that's quite a lot of difference, but then that's 5-6 rupees of intrinsic value that you may not make. If you actually want, you could do a bull spread and buy the 130 call at 460 and sell say the 150. You could sell two of those and get 1 rupee, and that would be giving away 1 rupee, 8,000, and your profit would be 19,000. That's actually damn good, right? 250% return. So that's a bull spread that you could think about. This definitely deserves a follow-up in terms of at least tracking how the trade went. Sid would be extremely happy to see this. I think should give him a call in the US and ask him to check this out. Okay, so that's Hindalco. Like I said, contrarian one, but well, given the overall state of the market, we'll look at that. Then we're looking at Jindal. I think Jindal was removed from the Nifty. Oops. And then yeah, once we've opened it. Big break. So this is the risk, and I'm glad we're looking at it. So again, picked up on high volumes. Has been bought here. There's, I think, that auction, the whole thing is not yet finalized, so maybe that, maybe some news. But look at this very, very impressive hammer that you have here, all the way from 119 to 110. That's a 10% hammer almost, 8% down, 8% up, and volumes are, of course, there. Broke down and then got back up. I'm just check if it's on result, it's on news. So 110 now, what's the low of this? 109.40 is, I think, the level to watch out for. If it recovers from here, you could have an excellent recovery all the way back to 150. So with a very big long lower shadow like this, I would look at buying it. Of course, metals are the exception today. They are the ones which are showing deep weakness, whereas all the other ones are showing a considerable amount of strength. Okay, then NMDC. Interesting. Whole metal pack. Another hammer on NMDC. What is going on? Symmetrical triangle, but Peter's out of the apex, so really not much of value. But 125 is, again, as you can see, a multi-year support level that it is on. And from 2008, this is really interesting. If you, it's always difficult to, you know, take a call on this, because is this 125 going to hold or not? It's consolidating. You can see the Bollinger Bands coming in tight. There's been, I wouldn't say low volumes, but okay. Tough to take a call on this. You might want to stay away. But on the other hand, if you just look at the Hindalco way, then this could give you a good return on an option. Look at the 130 call. Again, interesting. 130 call on NMDC, 130 call on Hindalco. Okay, next, look at Tata Steel. So some strength in the one metal stock, but no volumes. Well, now I'm wondering whether going long on Hindalco is a good idea at all. You might actually lose a considerable amount of money. So do one thing, you know, hedge the trade, or this is where something like Interactive Brokers would just be fantastic. Will 330 hold or not? Little tough to say. So no call on Tata Steel. Actually, all the metals are really, really weak, and this might be the only one which actually collapses a lot in case the market turns negative. So the Hindalco view is, I would say, not that bullish, right? But this pure technical analysis would be great if we had FA to back us up on taking a more fundamental view. But anyhow, in the lack of that, so just going back to Hindalco, you could also look at a straddle long, buying the 130 call and the 130 put, but it's going to be really expensive. But if it pays off, it really pay off well. If you can manage to square off, if the leg that's making your loss is quickly cut, then the one that is making you money could actually do you extremely well. On the other hand, you know what, if the stock goes above 133, then get into it. So there's a stop loss here of around 127. Actually, see, this is the dilemma. If you buy now, your stop loss is very low. If the stock is at 129, you can put 126, 127 as the stop loss. You're talking about 3 rupees. But if you let it go to 133 and then put 127, wait for the bounce, and you're talking about, you know, another 4 rupees unnecessary stop loss. So the question is, what is your view on this support holding? And if you look at individual stocks, there's really individual charts rather, there's no justification for a long. However, if I look at the overall market, and if I may, okay, just notice one more thing, but this could just be my bias, you know, considering that maybe looking for a long. Okay, now this is not my bias. So first of all, I've changed it to weekly chart. You can see the volumes coming down as the stock is consolidated on the side, and the volumes have been coming down since September of last year. What's most encouraging is the MACD crossover here on Hindalco, which is showing some strength on the weekly side, and the RSI has come closer to the 50 mark, though it is not above the 50 mark. Still a downtrend. Volumes have definitely come down, and this I'm just going back and forth, I think, but this could really be a good buy, I think, again, given this weekly MACD crossover. And on the daily chart, you'll see that MACD is actually it is giving us a bullish divergence. So there is the bullish divergence. I am suddenly remembering Bajaj Auto stock and how that gave you very healthy 15% return on that bullish divergence, and there is definitely a bullish divergence right now on both MACD and I would say RSI also. Of course, you have to ignore that little last bit, but overall, looks like things are turning around, and it's a high risk trade, but a worth, in my opinion, it's a trade worth taking. Right? Okay, so cool. So that's Hindalco, and then let's look at the banks finally. So actually, I don't even know whether you know, should look at the banks because subject to RBI policy announcement on 2nd, unless Rajan has already said something and I'm not aware of it, right? So okay, so indicators and all definitely looking healthy and all that. So we've got a move here to maybe definitely 600, 610, and once that goes, then definitely much higher prices on Axis Bank should be expected. Stop loss is below 540 only. 600 first, 620 next, and then much higher levels. So that would be Axis Bank. Then we have, I'll do the private banks first. SDFC. Wow. Very, very good volumes, but really nothing to do, no price action. 1250 looks like is causing it to stall for some time. If you're bullish, might be a good time to buy the 1250 call or whatever there is on this. Let's see. Yep, 1250 call is at 33 rupees. Lot size is 250. So we're talking about 7500, and if that breaks out well, then very quickly I think 1300 would happen. So that's 30, not a great deal. It'll have to go much higher than 30 for you to actually make decent money. Maybe 1340 may not be a great trade, but still something to watch out for, and maybe best left till Tuesday. This one, Axis Bank, looks healthier. Then we look at HDFC Bank. So this one has definitely gone up, no doubt about it. However, volumes are lacking, so that is a bit of a concern. And okay, 1090, very good supports all the way till 1000. Good time to buy would have been actually been 2 weeks back when it crossed 1000 rupees. It's gone from 1000 to 1050 and looks like it's headed to 1090. So stop loss is actually only below 1000, otherwise 1090, and then after that, once again, becomes a 1000 rupee stock, then it could definitely be going much, much higher. Right. So that is HDFC Bank, and then we've got ICICI Bank. So this one has not moved. Volumes are high on Friday, but no movement. So again, but at a good support. So these are the challenges. You have something where the risk reward, the risk is actually on an absolute basis quite on the low side because it has a good support. And if it breaks out, then you get a really good move. So really not a good symmetrical triangle here. This is not a good fit line. Probably that. If I am very conservative, then it's going to be a tough one. Alright, so we'll put it that. And not at the peak, but okay, falling volumes, that's what you want. And finally, let's see, stop loss below 305. First is 325 is the target, then 335 is the next target, right? And could be a good trade, and then all the way to 350, 360, and then even 380 is definitely possible on this. Typical symmetrical triangle. Breakout in the making is what I would expect, but again, the event risk with RBI policy is something that we can't ignore. Okay, so that is ICICI Bank, then IDFC. So IDFC is not really a bank, as you know, but there was a news article on Business Standard last week about IDFC doing a soft launch of IDFC Bank in June. Which is a surprise, because I thought that will happen much later. And like I kept saying, keep buying, because once the demerger happens, then it could make you a lot of money. So this one, 152, is obviously a good support. So this is not going to react the same way to RBI policy, but I think we've got good support level here. MACD doing a positive crossover, as you can see, but in the negative zone, so that's something. But as a trade, this is a good trade with a stop loss below, say, 150. You have to be patient. First resistance will be at 156, 157, and then 160 would be the next level that it would go to. Right, so yep, this is definitely a healthy place to look at it. And in this 150 or in this zone from 140 to 152, looks like there's a lot of bottoms or tops that have happened in the last few years, and this would definitely be a place to buy. Alright, then we've got IndusInd Bank. Okay, so interesting, up but not much volumes. So you're seeing this across the banks, that the volumes are really sort of lacking. That's probably in anticipation of waiting just for RBI to clarify. It's at a multi-year old resistance of 875. You could actually go long on this with a stop loss below 330, and once 875 breaks, then 900, 950 will very quickly happen, right? So that is, we don't need that. Okay, so that is IndusInd Bank, and then next is Kotak. So that's a good move, but no volumes. So it looks like, I think the banks are all like waiting for RBI. And this one, like we said, has been in a rectangle for about 3-4 months now. 1300 to 1450. Looks like, once it breaks out, and it should, the measuring implication of that would be 150 rupees. So that would be 1600, but 1500 would be the first level to watch out for, and then 1600 rupees could definitely be coming. Alright, so that is okay. Right, so this is interesting. There is nothing in the indicators also, as you can see, because all of them have sort of gone to their equilibrium point that can help us with the decision. So we just have to wait for the event to get out of the way before we can do anything on that. Okay, then we've got what do we have put up? Let's look at now the public sector bank. We start with State Bank of India. See that not much of a move, no volumes also. So doji almost. So these are just best to wait and watch. Multiple long-term moving averages also here, which are going to give support and resistance. So that's SBI and PNB. So that's the same actually, not much except for a very deep correction that it has had. So good example here of how, you know, divergences can fail and they don't always work. Market actually crashed, or not crashed, broke the support, went from 160 to 140. This time the RSI is looking healthier, so is the MACD, but it would be premature to do anything without the RBI event out of the way. Of course, here you have MACD showing some basing formation, RSI weekly showing, showing a bullish divergence. So good stop loss will be below 148, but once it clears 160, then 170, 175, and then 190, 200 is definitely possible. So that is PNB. And then we've got to look at Bank of Baroda. And well, all the public sector banks seem to be just sitting there, really not doing much. So BOB had this fantastic 20% move one day and fantastic volumes and has just consolidated from there. Unlikely it will break 155. So could buy. I think this would be the only buy I would give in public sector bank space. This is a trend line to watch out for. It's just there. And if it does break that, then definitely higher levels in the making. Okay, so giving that buy only because of this extremely high volume move that happened 3 weeks back. So I'm saying that even if something negative happens on SBI, on RBI policy, this may not, this is unlikely to fall below 145. So that's the protection reason why I'm saying, you know, buy. I know, very interesting how that is a multi-year support from which this perhaps just bounced off. So again, if you look back at Hindustan Unilever, sorry, Hindalco, that's the sort of level we are talking about at this point, except that here it went there very sharply and then just bounced back from there. What an amazing recovery. Three black crows and one huge marble. So this is exceptionally rare and something definitely to go back and look at what event or result caused it. So bullish on Bank of Baroda. It's Axis, IDFC, Indusind, and HDFC. All right, so that's it. We've covered all the. Yep, we have. Oh, there's one I missed. BHEL. All the banks are over. Remember, as far as the banks are concerned, RBI event risk. So you may not want to do the trade tomorrow, and you may want to use your trigger orders or do something with options for on Monday. Oh, sorry, on Tuesday. Okay. Right, so VHEL definitely good support here at 225. Excellent volume pickup for whole of last week on after 3 months of low volume basing formation, and then just a zoom. And this is what could happen in Hindalco. I don't know, just sticking my neck out here. And this would be technically a buy with excellent supports all the way to 235. So actually any dip should be used to buy now, not to exit. And the next target is 270. Maybe even 285. 270, 285 could be the next target. Who knows? And then we've got 350, 375. Alright. Yep. So we've finished the Nifty stocks. Right. So great. So exceptionally great recovery on this. Some fantastic buys. I think the question now is a question of too many choices, not enough money. The really way to narrow down on this would be to sit and do a lot more analysis based on the baseline analysis we have done, and figure out which would be the most profitable ones in terms of risk reward ratio, absolute return, percentage return, and then take a view on what would be the best ones for you. So I'll be sending out this note after the mail to everyone. And this was, this part is what we did part one, and this is what we did today, right? Part two, IMR. Everything is long. There's not a single short available or you should be looking at in the markets. And of course, not all the 50 stocks are mentioned here. The ones which I felt are the ones which deserve closer attention and put a high probability trade of what is here. Okay, so great. Thank you for your participation. The recording is going to take a little bit of time. It takes a little while to process and then upload. So it might happen, not might, it will happen only hopefully tomorrow morning. And in the meantime, I'll send out these notes, right? So great. Thank you so much. Have a great week ahead. Hope you make, some money, if not a lot of money, and watch out for the event risk on Tuesday, right? So great. Thank you and good night.